What's up, y'all? Spoiler alert, I'm working on story elements today. So you might not want to watch anymore if you don't want the story spoiled. The next story element I'm going to work on is when you go into the second swordless dungeon. So I think that's in this world, that's like 050. Is that right? No, the order changed. It's got to be somewhere else. Oh, that's this one now. What number is it? Huh. Six? I recently shuffled all the dungeon numbers, so it's a lot better for the game, but it's a little harder to debug because I'm still getting used to the order of the dungeons for my test world Xanadu. But once I got them all down, then it won't be as disorienting. Seven's this one. Five is probably that one. Maybe five. Oh, here it is. It's eight. Okay. Eight is the one. So we want to be at... back here, the overworld, figure out where the entrance to eight is. Wait a minute. Oh, this is the wrong saves file anyway. Copy current saves to saves? There. There's my good old save data. Data. What's up, Arcane? How you doing today, man? I'm going to check here. It's got that. We need the cup. Cool, you good? Yeah, I'm good too, man. What am I spoiling today? I'm spoiling some story elements. So, I'll be doing story elements that one of the story elements I have planned today is a big spoiler. So, that's why I did the big old spoiler alert. Okay, so we got that saved. Now I just gotta go to Dungeon 8's entrance. Dungeon entrance here. The problem is there's no story element that happens. First of all, Jim should freak out when you fall over. So you just fall over. Jim does nothing. So Jim needs to do something. Oh, thanks, man. Yeah. It's getting a little bit better. The map part needs to improve. The actual map needs to... there's a lot of things that need to improve there. I want it to show all four. There's like there's two directions on each side of the screen and two directions in the north and south that you can go in. So I want the map to actually show those individual paths so it's not as easy to get lost. And I also want the map to be able to zoom in and be a little bigger. But that'll all happen. Music one, music two. Okay. So we need a story element to happen when you fall over. Let's give you like phase. Well, there already is a phase for that. There's phase drink. So I guess we could do the animations here. And jib ID, find jib. Now, yeah, exactly, yeah. I want to show on the map if there's like multiple south exits, multiple west, east, north, all that. Right now it just shows one. Like if there's either of the south exits, if there's like the left south or the right south, it just shows one, which is kind of misleading if you're running around the map and you're looking at the map and you're like, oh, I can get there if I go to this screen. And then you get to that screen, you're like, oh, I can't get there because this particular map here is blocked off. So, you know, it could be a little bit better. Okay, so we're gonna make Jib do an animation and a sound effect. And M's Jib Talk, I think, should do it. Just so they can talk and do nothing. What's up, Rocket Bunny? How's it going, Rocket Bunny? Sound key, we want him to like whine a bit. What's that one where Jib whines? He's like, hurt? All these are kind of Jib fear, maybe. Fear or hurt? Or statue falls. What you doing today, Rocket Bunny? Jib, 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 jib. Okay, he's got fear. Oh, that's when you die. Hurt. Oh, that's when he actually gets hurt. Pain one, there we go. So we'll just call this one complain. So play complain and make him animate his talking effect, repeating like a little bit. And no delay, zero delay. I think Jib Talk's already set up to find Jib and stuff. You got into a fight at school? Oh, wow. What happened? And then you started implementing image loading. Sweet, there you go. Yeah, so some of the squares would be divided in half, yeah. Uh-huh. Did you win? It was kind of a tie. Wow, man. What was the fight about? That's cool, but I really want him to like move back and forth to the left, to the right. Flux duration 6.0. Okay. Yeah, we can get Jib to move around a little bit. So we can make him move to the left, move to the right. And I think I want him to complain a little longer. And there should be a little delay here. So like maybe half a second, 4.5. So that's only 1.5 seconds where he'll move around. Oh, you're playing hockey. Oh, man. It was epic. Oh, man. Okay, I want to divide this up into different phases. Lift sword. Oops. What? Ow. Phase lift sword end. Has this where? Here we go. Vector durations. Then we're going to call A equals 0, I equals 0, split alpha. All right, so we'll push back some durations. You got a bloody nose and a black eye, and you got a bruise. Yeah. Okay, so 4 seconds into this, he hits the ground. Animate, drink, and fall to ground. So then we do, let's say 1 second Jib goes to the left. And then another second Jib goes to the right. And then that'll be it for this. Oh, wait, we'll do one more little thing here. So there's a little bit of delay in here too. Duration. What do we need duration for? I don't think we need that. Let's do this flux duration. Set alphas. Okay. And then when we're doing the animate, We'll go this right here. Durations, zero. Chip talk, complain. Okay, so now we can do these effects. Instead of them being here, they can be inside this animate. So if I equals zero, or one, we're gonna ignore it. Wait, no. Well, right when he hits the ground, that's gonna be, yeah, if I equals one, hit ground, and we'll do bool first time. If hit ground and first time, then we play, we do this thing here, and we delay. So if else, if I, whoops, I is two and first time, that's when Jib will do his complaint. So we shouldn't need these anymore. Oh wait, we need to play the drink sound. So drink sound will be 0.9. Animate drink. Fall to ground will be 3.1. Okay. Okay. Yes it is, Rocket Bunny. Yes it is. So this is hit ground. This one is this is 0, 1, 2 is right when he starts delaying. Fall to ground. Oh yeah, 2 has hit the ground. Slash delay. 3 is Jib goes to the left. What's up, Air Fixa? So then, we don't want to set the flux duration there. Okay. We want Jib to complain. It's right after the delay, so we have no delay here. And we want Jib to start going to the left. So, new hero pause. Nice, Rocket Bunny. You got it all organized now. You got a make file too. Sweet, you're using make files? How organized. You got your main, you got your engine. Right on, man. Good for you. Check out source engine. Ooh, game object, graphics, inputs. Nice! I love how they're all headers. How convenient. That's really nice. Keep in mind that does slow down your compilation, but it's probably really nice and convenient to have everything there in a header. Sweet, dude. Oh, I bet that's so fun. So we need Jib's ID. New hero pause, Jib ID. We need to have Jib. What if we don't have Jib? If we don't have Jib, we'll check it right here. New hero pause dot jib ID equals old hero pause jib ID. And then new hero pause jib ID dot x minus equals say like around 20. And then the next phase will go to the right. Oh, and this needs to be. Yeah, all of this needs to be and first time. To right. Plus. Okay. Let's see if Jib moves. Let's see if all his timing's correct. I just want him to like complain, do his little animation, and then walk to the left, walk to the right. So he looks like he's frustrated, like he's just like, whoa, he's concerned, he's worried. Oh. Damn, I gotta go back to, where was that? I think it was 14.6. No, it's not the more headers. It's when you put code in headers. Because for every single file that includes the header, it has to recompile all that. Do you understand why? If you don't understand why, you really should check out how compilers work. You should do some research on that. That should really, really help out your understanding of what's going on when you hit compile. When you go and compile, you hit make or whatever it is you're doing to build your exe file. Get some basic understanding of what's going on there, how the compiler works, what's it doing, what's the preprocessor. And all that stuff. That's your homework, bunny. You got homework. Okay, we got the cup, we got Jib. Let's do this. Oh. Okay, it didn't do his sound effect when he hits the ground. Oh, I forgot that. Okay, it's supposed to do that here. Play this hit the ground sound. 0.9 seconds into it, which means right at I equals 1. Okay, oh, that should be I equals 1. That should play the sound effect. Why did Jib like instantly warped? That was weird. Well, Arcane, header files don't necessarily have to not have code. They can have code. That's totally allowed in C++. It's just that it has to compile that for every single file that includes the header file. It has to go and recompile that code. So that's why it slows down your overall compilation, unless you're only including that header in one file, and then it's you know, the exact same time. But if you the moment you include the header file in two files, it's going and compiling that code twice. That's probably one of the biggest problems about C++ is how slow it compiles. Especially the headers are just kind of a nightmare. Yep, GCC, G++ is available on every platform. Okay, I'm gonna confirm that it's not doing this multiple times. Cool, the sound effect was good. Okay, I want to run this a couple times and see if this hits this breakpoint more than once. No, okay, that was fine. So what's going on here? Let's see this one more time. Yeah, I know, right? The two files. It's kind of an archaic system. Look at languages like C#. C#, that's one of the best parts about C#. I think maybe I need to design like an old position for Jib. Let's do vec2 Jib start pause. Jib start pause equals entity get position component for find jib dot pause. Why not have it like other programming languages? Well, the reasoning behind it all is that the people that made C++ and all that, they're trying to make it easier for the compiler. And because having a header file makes it a little bit easier for the compiler, I can't exactly give you good reasons why. I forget why. But if you do some research, basically header files make it a little bit easier for the compiler. And secondly, they make it a lot better for library writers. So if somebody goes and writes a library, right? Some framework, some basic thing, and they don't want to give away their source code. So they basically give you just the header files, and then they give you some lib files, so they're compiled C++ files or CPP files. So basically the header files make it so you can still use their API, you can use the library they wrote, but you don't have access to their source code. So there is that. You know, if you got rid of that, you kind of would, I'm not sure how you would. It's just that it'd be nice if header files were optional, you know what I mean? Like if you didn't necessarily have to use header files. If you're writing all your code yourself, you know, it'd be nice if you didn't have to use header files for your own game engine where you already have access to all your own source code. But for library writers, I guess it would still be a good thing to have header files. I don't know, maybe there's some other better reasons out there. Maybe somebody else can chip in. Help me out on this. Am I talking nonsense? Nonsense as usual. Okay, so we'll set new hero pause jib ID to just start. Jib start pause. I think old hero paws needs to be updated. Does it? Maybe not. I don't know. Yeah, Farpoke. Yep. All right, Koken. C sharp keeps function name, etc. in the DLL, so no need for header files. Oh, really? Is that how it works? Oh. Has the access modifier internal, extra to public. Internal means public inside of its own DLL, but outsiders. Oh. Oh. That is really neat. I like that about C sharp a lot. Once again, he's instantly warping. Why are you instantly warping, man? Yeah, there's definitely at least a homebrew. Brew Surge GCC. Yeah, there's definitely a homebrew for it. Probably a G++. Yeah, a header basically is an interface. If you're thinking of like an Objective-C interface, is that what you're talking about? Okay, so he should be walking at this point. I don't know why he's not. Partial classes, properties, delegates. Yeah, it's a nice higher level language than C++. Oh, if only it had the portability and the speed. I know you can get C# to be almost as fast as C++. So it's really not that big of a deal, but. Jib, what are you doing, Jib? Tick heroes. There's a function called tick heroes. It's supposed to remove the hero positions. Yeah, I don't even know what a partial class is. Yes, you can define functions anywhere you want. Oh, yeah. Oh, it's just different names and stuff. The dreaded green potion. Legend of Kirania? Is that a cool game? I've never even heard of it. Legend of Kirania. Usually not relevant, true, but like for a game like, for example, in my own game here, Songbringer, I know there's sections of code that would really benefit from raw speed. Like, for example, the world generation. Generating the entire world takes a while. I mean, in C++, it's pretty fast. It's like under half a second. But if you were to introduce even just a slight delay to all, there's so much code it's running in that half second that even if a slightly slower code base would run that, you know, that would take maybe a second or 2 seconds. Or on older systems, older computers, maybe that would take like 10 seconds. That would be crazy. Crazy, man. Oh, this is old school. Adventure. Nice. Is this a good game? Oh, it's like Monkey Island-ish? Oh, C# generics are better than C++ templates? Why is that? C++ templates are kind of confusing. It's totally my Monkey Island adventure-y. Can only recommend it to everybody. Has anybody played Owlboy? I want to know if Owlboy is good. Old paws, new paws. Oh, nice, nice. It should be moving jib. Tick heroes runs. It loops over each hero. It makes a reference to his old position and his new position. It sets his last position. If the old pause isn't zero and the new pause isn't zero. Ew, it does do an alpha based on. The final station? Oh, yeah, I've seen that one. Not too convinced, yeah. I gotta watch some more of it. Dot? Which one's Dot? Looks good? Yeah. Okay, I'm gonna set a breakpoint here, but disable it. And then back here, when it starts doing this, set a breakpoint here, so we know when it first does this. And so I can hit this breakpoint and then enable the other one and figure out why. Are there if statements in make files? Yes, there are, but they're kind of cumbersome. They're kind of tricky to use. Kind of the best thing to do is to kind of use all your if statements before you're actually doing your make actions. Okay, here we go. Go to tick heroes. G-Buddies 3, that looks good. Okay, so what entity are we on now? This is the first, this is rock, now jib. Okay, cool. Jib, what you got? Old paws, new paws. 159, 139, that looks great. Yep, loop from 139 to 140. Oh, I think I know what it is already. The alpha. The alpha is going to be crazy because the alpha is based on. Yeah, this is already 0.69. So it's instantly going to warp him to us. Oh, I get it. Okay, I see why that's not working. So we just want to move. Let's just move him. Move him over time. Don't worry about this. We'll just go jib ID is greater than zero. Get jib. In fact, we could just go int jib. Int jib. Find jib. And jib.id is greater than zero. So jib.position. Did the stream? I don't think the stream crashed. Is it? Oh, your stream's glitching too? La 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 la. I think it's okay. Ah, okay. What's up, Proton? How you doing? Jib dot position dot last pause equals jib dot position dot pause. And the jib's position dot pause is a mix of jib start pause and back to jib end pause equals jib start pause dot x minus 20 jib start pause dot y. So there we can mix jib start pause and jib end pause based on the sub alpha, which is a there. So we can do the same thing for this next little phase where we go jib end pause is the jib start pause. Wow, yeah, we could just do this opposite. How do you decide where to go when you're in between a bunch of development tasks in a game? That's a great question, Farpoke. Such a great question. I'll give you some thoughts on how on kind of how I think about that. How do you decide where to go? Where do you do? What do you do next in game development? Yeah, man, that's such a great question because it's so applicable. Like you have that all the time, especially in a long-term game development project. You're constantly like, what do I do next? What I like to do is to focus on what excites me the most, because usually when you're in a state of transition, when you're in between tasks, you're kind of in this almost a vulnerable state where you can be affected quite a lot by things, and where like a certain bug can slow you down so much or you know, like, I don't know. So I like to focus on what excites me the most in those kind of things. So when I'm wondering what to do next, or when I'm in between some tasks, I just like decide what's the most exciting thing to do right now. And I don't know if that works for everybody, but it works really well for me, because that's another thing too, with especially with long-term projects, you've got to keep your excitement levels or your interest levels for your project up, because otherwise you quit on your project. You end up being like, I'll just do something else. So if you're not excited about your project, what's the point, you know? So that works really well for me, just to focus on whatever is the most exciting thing. Maybe that helps. It's worked really well for me. I've done lots of projects that are multi-year projects. So, okay, let's exaggerate this. Let's make this really, Oh, this is only first time. Okay, gotta take away this. If first time we do the jib complain, otherwise we want to do this position interpolation in every single one of those. Yeah, you're welcome. And I kind of apply that same kind of concept to a lot of things, like especially when I get bored with something. Like a lot of times I'll get bored with code. Be like, oh my god, I've been doing this code for so long, or I get stuck on bugs, I'm like, I'm so tired of this bug, and I'll switch phases, like I'll switch into a different little task or a different project, whether that's, a lot of times I'll switch from code to art, or I'll switch from art to sound making, or sound making to programming, whatever. Switching tasks really helps to keep things fresh. Whoa, he was really jittery there. Oh, that's because we gotta disable his old position. So old hero pause jib ID equals new hero pause jib ID equals back to zero. So that disables the other functionality where it uses tick heroes to move the hero. So we can just move them manually. Yeah, there definitely is. Yeah. GCC. Is it GNUC? Is that the one? Oh, this is jib.id. Man, this took a minute. All I wanted was for Jib to move to the left and then move to the right. This is taking like a half an hour. Man, I kind of need a better story system. Or just update a bunch of code that uses my old story system to the new story system. There! Yeah! Oh, great. So great. Also, Jib needs to look to the right. So if first time... jib.render.sprite.setflippedx false. And then also he needs to set flipx true here. And he can move a lot farther. Or just complain for less time. Originally, this was 1.5, I think, total. I don't know, let's just do a half a second each direction. Ooh, nice. C standard bool, H, huh? I'm liking it. I'm liking it a lot. Let's do it a couple times, actually. You can go to the left, then the right, then the left, then the right. So if I equals 3, or 5, this one will be I equals 4, or I equals 6. Oops. Back to the point. 14, 6. Jib. We lost Jib! What happens if we don't do it without Jib? Still works? Nothing crashes? Cool. Jib 2. Give me back the Jib! I need some Jib! That's kind of funny. I think he should move a little less. Let's do 15. Let's do one more. Maybe the last one's a little shorter too. Oh. I love Jim. I think this needs to be a little less. There we go. That was better. Cool. All right. Check that in. Little animation for Jibby Jib. Complain. Phase drink. It's a lot more detail here with Jib moving around. Let's check that for real. Vector durations. We made some durations. The overall flux duration is a composite of that. Or some. We set Jib's start position, and then the animate handles, splitting it up, playing the drink sound, hitting the ground, setting your offset Y, Jib going to the left, Jib going to the right. I didn't ever pay attention to if your shadow offset works, so let me check that too. Shadow's still looking good. Hit the ground. Shadow looks fine. Okay, good. How do you compile to a DLL? Yeah, I can try that. Let me just do it for the last one, the first. That means I need a different Jib start pause and end pause. Chib Star Paws. Chib In Paws. So if it's first time, you set Jib in, Jibs in Paws. All right, let's see if it still is doing it. Cool. Let's make him go a little faster too each time. So we'll start at point 3, goes to like point 2.7. Two, three, and then point 2. Okay, so the last loop, if I equals 9, Jib in Paws dot Y plus equals, oh, well, he needs to be, if he's, it's going to be 10 times if jib.position.pause is less than, let's get, hero equals game scene. Yeah, let's just do int. Int get shadow. So if Jib's position dot pause dot y is less than the hero's position dot pause dot y, then Jib will be moving upwards. Otherwise, Jib will be moving downwards. Okay, and then the very last one where he's here equals 10, then we want to not even set the jib and pause because we'll keep it the way it was. Oh, in fact, geez, we don't even need jib and pause to change. We just want to, actually, the only thing we need to change here is jib start pause. So jib start pause dot y plus equals 10 times, yep, same thing. So there he moves 10 each time, which is probably a little too much. Probably just do 5. 5, 5. Okay, cross your fingers and see if it works. Cool, it worked. Let's make sure it works if he's above. I'll set a bool up here. Bool jib south equals that. So we also want to do his run north if we want to do jib dot render dot no jib dot move dot last compositor equals jib south, cater north, otherwise cater south. So this will make him turn around, and then that'll work. And then we also want to do his running animation, or let him scan him. Oh man, yet another step. I didn't want to work on this long. Would it be cool for him to scan him? Let me just finish this first. So I think he needs to run a different run animation. Maybe I did set the compass direction. Let's see if that works. It really doesn't matter if he's facing the right direction, actually. I guess you could set this at the beginning, before he even does his animate. Or right when he does his jib talk. That would be right there. It's facing north. Huh, I think his talk animation is only south. Okay, let's see what happens though if he's north of him. Okay, this is good so far. I'm gonna check this in and move on to the next step. Okay, so we get into here. Rock goes through this dungeon. You want him to, once he comes out, there'll be some dialogue with Jib. Trigger this. So inside this dungeon, you get the shield, which I already have. How many shields do I have? Just one. Okay, so if you have the shield, yeah, I mean, you have to get the shield to be able to get out of this dungeon. So, okay, that'll work. Let's do a story action. You can call it After Swordless 2. If you have the shield and you're back at the overworld and Jib is there and you're done with the flux, then we'll do some dialogue called After Swordless 2. Now let's make some After Swordless 2 dialogue. Thank you. All right, cool. There we go. We got that started. I got nuts. So now I really want to get on to this last bit where I'm going to start working on a bigger story element. Where do we want this to be? Let's go back to eight. Just go back to eight. That's all. That works. At least there's some dialogue there, and now I can go back and improve it later on if I have any adjustments I want to make to that dialogue or whatever. It's all in place. It's working. So let's check that in too. And same thing, Irokoken, you made a great suggestion there of like scanning him after he falls down. I don't have the time to put that into that right now because I would have to go and re kind of do what I just did there again. And make it so he moves closer every time and to the point where he can scan him and all that. So, but it's a great idea. So maybe I'll do that later. So I'm gonna check this in and go to the next story element. This is gonna be a big spoiler alert. So if you care about the plot, probably not a good stream to watch. Now we need to be on so on Songbringer. Think it's right here. Oh wow, I was running at 60 today. Okay, so let's see if we have. Yep, we can fight her. All right, we're gonna go into the next room, fight the lightning boss. Kill the lightning boss, and we're gonna do a crazy countdown. Like, run! Countdown! When it gets to zero, everybody dies. Okay, how do we do that? We're gonna need to do this. Could be a NIMS. We need a story element right for when the boss dies. So the boss, the lightning boss. Jeez. Can't find it. There. All right, we want render track status. AI track status? Where the which one is track status go on? Health flags, that's right. All right, so health flags, track status. So now we can know when this boss is dead. We could trigger an action. What's up, Adon? How you doing? How you been? I'm good. Similar to Dead. Roz Mini Boss Dead. I guess we can throw this at the end. Lightning boss victory. So the Z is going to be the ship dungeon. Ooh, I don't know if this is, well, I guess that would be Z10. We have to have killed the lightning boss. Wait, that might need to be all lowercase. Yeah. Lightning boss dead. And is complete. I guess we could do flags boss. Flags boss complete. Oh, that's a lot easier. Let's do an anims alarm. And then a delay. Nah, maybe no delay. Okay, so that should just play a sound effect and do an alarm thing when the lightning boss dies. And if it doesn't work, I'm just going to take this off because I think that's not even necessary, really. How you been, Adon? What's up? So yeah, it did not work. Probably because of the timing of it all. So let's just do is complete and get rid of the whole track status. We don't really need that. We're not going to use that. I think this will work. We're just going to need Z10, flags boss, is complete. Do that. Spoiler alert! Nice! Okay, I'm gonna simplify the alarm now. So I want the alarm to keep running for a long time and there to be a countdown. So anims alarm, we want this to run like so much, like how long will it take you to get out of here? Let's do 60 there. And simplify scan alarm. Save, let's just export one of those now. Scan alarm one. And then for the other alarm sequence, kind of take that off. We don't really need it anymore. And just do alarm And for repeating this alarm effect. Alarm. Names. This alarm will automatically play the alarm sound. Fade to. Here we go. Call funk. Create. Kit play sound. Scan alarm one. And I guess we could make this a little more flexible. So the alarm function could have a sound file that passes in. We can capture that here and play it. So, scanner rock anims, da da da. This is gonna be scan alarm one. Oops. And we'll parse that. So, an action anims. This is from the story system. Still streaming? You guys still there? La la la. Can you still hear me? I did just open up Ableton. Sometimes Ableton doesn't kills the audio. Bunny, so there. All right, cool. Good to know. So then const auto or const string sound equals words the size is greater than 4. It's gone quiet. Yo, just the chat. Yeah. Words 4, otherwise nothing. And then pass that in sound. Okay. I want to make sure the sword boss still works. Mini TIE Fighter. Why does it look all black? It's so weird. swear I just fixed that this morning. Fix that later. Okay, so what do we need here? Copy current saves. That looks good. Whoops. Thanks, bunny. Okay, so back to the ship. When we kill this guy, we're gonna run an alarm for like a whole bunch of times. Okay, I'm gonna set a little timer and see how long this takes to get out of the ship. Actually, I'm gonna check in what we did so far. That's already good. Story, scan alarm one, nims. Yep, we can pass in a sound effect for that. We've got the lightning boss victory thing started. Yep. Cool. Okay, so I'll set a timer. Stopwatch, there we go. Okay, the stopwatch has been started. So how long does it take to get out of the ship, approximately? Reminds you, what's on that YouTube? Okay, obviously this is gonna be totally different for each one of these. This could be a lot longer, it could be a lot shorter. This one was actually pretty easy. There was a tunnel that led right back to the beginning. So that took 1 minute. 1 minute and 10 seconds. Okay, let's do that again for a different world. Oh, the Super Metroid escape sequence. That's what it's inspired by. Yeah. Super Metroid is one of my favorite video games ever. And I've always been putting like elements that are kind of similar to Super Metroid into this game. Totally. In honor of that and The Legend of Zelda. But it has a different story element that's going on in Songbringer, which I haven't finished yet. I haven't even started yet, but It's kind of the same thing. You just got to get off the ship. Get off this. Well, I guess in Super Metroid, you're getting off the station. Let's try a different world seed. Like, Tyrio. Where was I? Five. I think it was like about 6-5-6-6-5-0. Nope, not zero. 10, 6-5-10. Yeah, there'll definitely be something like that. There's gonna be a counter on the screen, and if the counter goes all the way down, you die. So it should lead to a pretty hectic feeling situation. There'll be the red flashing, definitely some music, something really like intense. Okay, start the timer. What? Oh no! We already did this. Okay. Take off the story element! What is it again? Lightning boss victory. Let's do this again. Adjust the timer based on the dungeon's number of rooms? Yeah, totally, there is. Aru, is this a game of developer for you? What you mean? Okay, set the timer. Well, this dungeon always has the same amount of rooms. So, I guess the way to do it would be to walk back the critical path. Oh yeah, I could just get the critical path. But no, the critical path doesn't account for tunnels yet. So, I would need to walk back through the whole world. Or through this dungeon. Along the tunnels. That's the important part, is this... Wait, do I need this tunnel? No, see, you gotta be smart as you go out. Because I could totally walk through that one. Okay, so that took also about a minute. But that one kind of was easy. Six, five, ten. Let's go back there. Try a different world seed. Okay, so the thing is, like, I could do that, right? I could walk through the entire... I walk through the dungeon, back through the tunnels that you're supposed to take to get there, using the shortest path, and then set a timer based on that. But that still doesn't really account for the player making mistakes and stuff. It's almost easier to just kind of set a timer that's a little longer than it needs to be. Besides, I want there to be some extra time here, so you can do something like a save the animals, kill the animals type thing. Not that it will be save the animals or kill the animals, but it will be some kind of choice the player makes, which will cost them time in their run, but do something story-based or visual. Let's try this world. steps. A lot of things to remember to reset each time. Save the frames! Kill the animals! Something like that. Something to make it really interesting for runners. People that are trying to speedrun this. And they have to make that choice. Maybe even make it into some kind of critical choice. Like, it's a really important choice to make for the story. Or an item you get. I don't know. But I love that. I love that about Super Metroid. The save the animals, kill the animals thing. I'm not even sure if the developers of Super Metroid knew what they were doing when they did that. Or knew what they had started. Save kill Jim. Oh, spoiler alert. Spoiler alert. It's like you're reading my mind. This one's a really easy path too. Are these all kind of like easy paths? You know what? Oh, that is the way the tunnels work. Oh, I forgot. The tunnel you have almost always leads back to the first level of the dungeon. So yeah, each one of those times I did it in 1 minute because they're really, it's not like you have to go through multiple tunnels to get out. It simplifies this whole situation. Okay, so I got out in a minute each time. I'm thinking though we should give the player like 3 minutes. I don't know. We'll start with 3 minutes. If it's too much, you can always tone it down a little. All right, let's go back to World Seed Xanadu. Reset all this so we can do it again. Man, I should just save it like this because I don't want to do that again and again and again. Okay, save that. Okay, now we need a timer on the screen. So how many alarms are there gonna be? And we'll do a timer too, so. Story, lightning boss victory. We've got an Anim's alarm, and then we also wanna do like an Anim's countdown. And countdown, if it's 3 minutes, that's 180 seconds. And if it's 1.5 seconds per alarm sound effect, 180 divided by 1.5, that's 120, what? That's not right, is it? Oh yeah, okay, so there's 120 alarm sounds that go off. And if you get to a different Z, the alarm will stop and the countdown will stop too. So action alarm or an IMS alarm needs to take note of the current Z. Huh, I wonder if it can actually do that. If it can kill itself. That's what I'm thinking. Like, each time it repeats this loop, can it check this current Z and then kill itself from the call funk? I'm not sure if it can. Guess we can try it, though. I'm almost certain this is gonna crash or something. Oh, we could schedule an. Oh, no, this is totally possible. Yeah, if the z is not equal to the same z, then we can just schedule an after update function. That's what these are for. Schedule after update. Schedule that. Capture the layer pointer. And layer pointer. Stop. All actions and layer pointer remove from parent and clean up truth. You had to get hostile with the sandwich. Oh man. Oh dang, I'm sorry to hear that. It should delete it if you change your Z. Now we'll do the countdown effect. Countdown's just like a number of seconds. Actually, I think I want to check and see if this alarm thing works, if it disables itself. If you get out. Okay. Cheating! Baby? What? Yeah. Okay. Oh, damn it. I didn't pay attention. Did that actually stop at the right time? Do over. It definitely stopped. Stopped early, that's for sure. Starting to get hungry. Almost got her before she got away. Oh, wait a minute. If you go downstairs, it'll stop. I think it will. Nice. Okay, we got out. That worked. But I think if you were to go downstairs, we need to compare level Z's. So constant get level Z is not equal to constants. Get level Z. And do it again. So there, I should be able to go down in a tunnel now, and it should still continue doing the alarm. How long I've been streaming, man? I'm getting hungry as heck. I think this is going to be it. I'll finish this countdown later after dinner. Okay, so yeah, thanks a lot for watching this, everybody. You've seen I've been working on some story elements. These are total spoiler alerts. Definitely going to be something big happens here when Songbringer's got this whole alarm going off and stuff. So I'm not going to say exactly what's happening, but if you pay attention to the streams about this time, you'll find out. Or if you play the game, you'll find out. Good. Okay, so it's still functioning fine inside this tunnel, which is a different Z. So a couple things. I'll want to take away all the enemies while this alarm is going off. So there'll be some kind of like Boolean or something in the game somewhere where it's like, this is an alarm sequence and a countdown. So it won't create foes. And also you shouldn't be able to use your teleporter. So, you know, if you try and throw down the teleporter, it'll stop you. There, if you make it back, you're okay, but if not, you die. So, thanks a lot for watching, everybody. I'll be back probably tomorrow, and I hope y'all have a great night. Thanks again.